Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Rusty Hutson from Diversified Energy Company. Rusty, how are you getting on?
We're getting along well, thanks.
Good. Great to have you on the line. And some very positive news this morning. You've raised your dividend. What can you tell us?
Yeah, we announced a dividend this morning, a 3% increase on the annualized dividend. Obviously, cash flows are strong. Cash flow yields are strong. And just made sense to share some of that back with our shareholders.
Well, they must be delighted. Now, I noted in your release that you said that this is a vindication of your very simple business model. So could you actually just remind us what that simple business model is?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, we acquire producing wells. We put some time and attention into them. We operate them more efficiently. We enhance production on them. We drive margins and cash flows, and we pay a dividend to our shareholders. It's a pretty simple model, one that I've been pretty successful employing over the last 21 years.
How do you see the future for the gas that you're getting out of the ground there? Do you feel like the high prices that we've seen recently are going to be able to be maintained?
Well, I don't know if, you know, at $8 to $9, here in the U.S. anyway, $8 to $9 natural gas prices will continue to be the norm. But I would expect that there will be a strong macro behind the natural gas market. And we should see a pretty strong range of 3 to 5 natural gas price for the foreseeable future. And if you really look out on the futures curves here on the NYMEX futures, you see that. And for us, that's a great place to be because, you know, one of the things that we do pride ourselves in is low cost. And so while costs are low, while we maintain a very low cost structure, you know, the $3 to $5 natural gas price is pretty significant for us in being able to, execute on our business model and also to perform very well as it relates to our margins and cash flows.
So you do take pride in keeping costs low, but I think there was a certain unavoidable increase in your expenditure this year. Could you tell us a bit about it?
Yeah, well, it just comes with the commodity price. I mean, you've got variable costs that are attached to the gas price or the oil price, and you really don't have any control over that. What we want to do is control the costs that we can, which is our fixed cost, our G&A, our lease operating expenses that are associated with taking care of the wells. And we're very vertically integrated, which means that we're able to maintain a much lower cost structure because we're not relying on a lot of outside services to operate our wells. And so that's given us the ability to keep our costs down. But you definitely have some variable costs that are attached to the cost or the price of the commodity that you just can't avoid.
I mean, that must be the cost of energy. Is there anything else?
Well, you've got electricity costs on some of your well pads. You obviously have property taxes or that are attached to the commodity price, production taxes on the oil and gas that you're producing. All of those are kind of, and then some gathering and transportation that are attached to the commodity price. So those are all costs that will go up as the commodity price goes up, but then your commodity price is offsetting it. And therefore we're still able to maintain pretty significant margins.
Fantastic. So speaking of margins, how confident are you that you're going to be able to maintain this strong performance heading into, say, the next 6 months?
Well, I mean, Thomas, we've been doing this for 21 years. We've over the last 4 years, when gas prices were $2, we were still 50%+ margins. We hedge, we lock in our gains, we lock in our margins, we lock in our cash flows, make sure that there's plenty of cash for, you know, paying down our debt. And paying our dividends to our shareholders. So we keep it pretty conservative. We don't want to roll the dice. We play the long game, which is what we are. We're the long game. We're not in it to try to turn a quick profit and you know, try to do everything in the next 6 months. It's longevity, sustainability, and comfort with our shareholders that we're doing all the right things that we can be successful long term.
Well, Rusty, I see there's obviously great merit in keeping it simple, and we're going to keep it short and simple today. So thank you very much for joining me here on Proactive.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.